Good afternoon, everyone. How are you doing? Good? Excellent. Let's get started. The good and the bad of SoCs. The good, of course, is this bring a lot of quality to our life. More compute function, faster functionality, and of course the mobility that comes with smartphones, IoT, all the applications that are battery powered. And for us in the industry, job security. Because it's more integration of functionality, which means there's more verification and validation. As Harry says, it grows at double exponentiation rate for the cost of increase in verification and validation. Of course, we're all under pressure to reduce schedules as well. So you have to put all this functionality together, verify it and validate it, and deliver it in months. That creates the SoC challenge in verification and validation. By definition, SoC has a processor core where you can run general purpose code for the most part, and it's surrounded by a number of peripherals and accelerator blocks like GPUs, neural networks. And when you have a processor core, that means there's software driving all this, lots and lots of software, bare metal software, drivers, OSs, middleware, application software. And even before you get to validating the functionality with all the software on top of it, there's a lot of software that's actually written to drive the verification of the hardware as well. Software is the key here, and we'll get more into that. We also have general purpose SoC platforms that are being developed so that specialized derivatives of that SoC can be done for various target markets. That means more software is developed to specialize, customize for these markets, increasing the pressures on time to market and to deliver it with quality.